Hello all, welcome to the session of Blender. In today's session, we are going to see how I am going to create a vase using Bezier curve and then to work with screw modifier. In the previous video of mine, you will see that I have created vase using subdivision modifier. So we can try to customize our vase in a more different way by using our Bezier curve. So to start off with this session, I am not going to work with cube, so I am deleting the cube. I will select my Bezier curve. So I will go to my curve and then select my Bezier curve. Now if you see this curve closely, this curve is flat on this surface. So let me make it into a proper way. So I will select R for rotation, Y for Y axis, and then at an angle of 90. Then I will take it to R. Then let's make it to Z and come to 90. So this is how my curve looks like. I will just take it up a bit. So I will just say G. And take it up so that it gives a proper kind of structure. So this is what my curves look like. This is the basic curve. So let's modify this curve to have a kind of shape. So when I want to modify, I'll select my tab option. So in my tab, you can see this path which is there, which gives my curve. So let's try to have a different kind of way of making this curve. So when I want to change, I'm going to work with two operations of my keyboard. That is G is for translation, E, X for extruding more curves, and then your R is for rotating. So let me start with my rotation first. So I'll take my R. I want it to look like a vase. I'll zoom out. E is for extruding it out more, so I have one more curve which looks like this. R is for making in a proper way. Again, I will extrude one more, so it gives me a proper kind of a vase look. I'll just rotate it a bit. So yeah, this is how I'm having a structure of my vase. I'll just rotate this point a bit. Yes, so this is how I've made my curve with extrusion E, with translating the object with G and rotating with R. So let's apply my modifier. So I'll go to modifier, I will add modifier, and then go up to screw modifier. So moment I select screw modifier, you will see some object like this. Now this is the object about the z-axis. When I select my x-axis, you can see clearly about my x-axis, how does my vase look like. If I go to my y-axis and see this, this is how it looks like in my y-axis. Now when I go to my x-axis, you will see some kind of shape for the vase. So when I go to my edit mode and then increase this a bit, so I will select again my R. As you can see, as and when I'm translating my object, I'm getting a different structure of vase. This is how I've made my vase using my modifier, that is my screw modifier. Now let me duplicate this and give different kinds of shapes. So when I duplicate this object, I will say Shift D. This is one, Shift D, another one. Shift D, another one. I'm trying to make four different kinds of vase. Let's start with the first one. We'll keep it as it is. Let's add color to the first one. So I will go to materials, to go to nodes, and then give it a color as well as the metallic look, so it looks good. So this is my one vase. Let's make go for the second one. So when I select my tab, I have different kinds of my curve. So let me just try to modify a curve and give it a different kind of shape. So I will select my this curve first and then take it a little higher. I'll take this curve. give it a different kind of shape and then rotate it a bit. Whichever way we want, we can transform this object so you can have a different kind of shape. However, I want inwards, outwards. Let me just make it to this much. Yes. So this is how my second vase looks like. So I'll go to my materials, add new material, give this a color, give it the metallic look so it looks good. This is my second vase. Let's move to the third one. Again, I will go to my edit option. Let me try to give it a different kind of structure. This is the structure of my vase. So let's give this a color. So I'll go to color, add. Let's go for the next one and give a different shape. I'll go to tab mode. I'm trying to give it a circular kind of look. Yes, this is my another vase. So now I'm going to add color to it. So add visible nodes. Again, give metallic look. So these are my four different vases which I have, which I've made using the Bezier curve and then applying my screw modifier. So we can give any kind of shape, any kind of texture by just working with the curves and then finally give it a different kind of look with the modifier called as the screw modifier and Bezier curve. Thank you.